Hello, my dear students. I am Dr. T. Pandiraj, working as Assistant Professor, Department of Agronomy, College of Agriculture Campus, Kotwa, Ajamgarh, Acharya Narendra Dev University of Agriculture and Technology. So, today we are going to see very interesting topic, that is System of Rice Intensification, shortly it is called SRI. The popularity of rice as a staple food has increased in number of countries like Africa, Latin America. You see, these are the countries where it is not traditionally a major food crops. Globally, rice covers an area of about rice covers an area of 162.06 million hectare, and the production level in globally it is 755.04 metric tonnes. Okay, so this is the global status of rice production in 2019. So globally, 162 million hectares rice growing with an annual production of 755.04 million tonnes. So Asian countries alone account for 85% of the world acreage and 89.63% of the world production. So you see, in Asian countries accounts for 85% of the total acreage, and the production is, it contributes 90% of the total rice production countries, whereas our India, so rice grown in India in 44 million hectares. Which is the largest area after China among all rice growing countries, with rice production of 118 million tonnes. This is area and 117.94 million tonnes. So our India is the second largest rice growing countries after China. But you see, in India, water used for paddy cultivation ranged from 1200 millimeter to 2500 millimeter depending upon the soil. So 2500 millimeter water is required to complete entire life cycle of rice crops. So do you know how much water required to produce 1 kg of rice? Exactly. So to produce 1 kg of rice, we need almost 2500 liters to about 5000 liters water. So just to imagine, this much amount of water has to be given to produce 1 kg of rice. So that means this rice consumes luxuriant amount of water for producing 1 kg of rice. So it is reported that the groundwater level in India has declined by 61% between 2007 and 2017. See, 61% water decline between 2007 and 2017. So 61% of groundwater decline between this year. So every year this is the problem. Every year the groundwater level is declining sharply. Of the extracted water, 89% is used for irrigation. Such an alarming rate of declining groundwater is urging scientists and growers to choose new approaches for increasing the water productivity of rice. So, the system of rice intensification is one among the scientific management tools for utilizing irrigation water based on soil and climatic condition to achieve maximum crop production per unit of water applied over a unit area in unit time. So, the system of rice intensification is known as SRI. It is a climate smart agroecological methodology for increasing the productivity of rice, changing the management of plants, soil, water, and nutrients. So, the system of rice intensification was first developed by French Priest. Father Henry D. Lalaine. So Henry D. Lalaine is the first person discovered SRI, that is system of rice intensification, in 1980s. The main aim of system of rice intensification to find out sustainable agricultural practices which lead to higher agricultural productivity, higher input use efficiency, and higher labor use efficiency. So these are the main aim. In 1983, after 2 decades of experimentation of French Henry D. Lalaine, synthesized the system of rice cultivation. In the broadcasting, one has to use about 100 to 120 kg seeds for 1 hectare. For broadcasting, one has to use 100 to 120 kg seeds per hectare, whereas for planting one has to use 30 to 40 kg seeds for 1 hectare, whereas in our SRI system we need just 4 to 10 kg seeds per hectare. So that's why, so this system of rice intensification has a main role on saving inputs. So ultimately it decreases the cost of cultivation. So now we will see different principles of system of rice intensification. So there are 6 major principles involved in system of rice intensification. The first principle is young seedlings between 8 to 12 days old are transplanted for better formation of tillering and rooting ability, because the best growth will come from seedlings just 8 to 12 days old and not older than 15 days. Dear students, you may ask, this 8 to 12 days old seedlings can applicable for all the regions? No. Physiological age is more important than calendar age. So, technically we recommend transplanting at the 2-3 leaf stages, that is before start of the 4th pilocron. This leaf stage is applies across all climatic condition, because calendar age may vary from region to another regions. For instance, in cold regions, the age of young seedlings can be 15 to 20 days or even more. Second principle is careful planting of single seedlings. For SRI, seedlings are planted singly rather than in clumps of 3, 4 or more seedlings. Whereas in conventional practice, seedlings are planted
clumsy of 3 to 5 seedlings per hill. Third principles is, seedlings are planted in square pattern, that is 25 by 25 centimeter wider. Don't plant in rows. In case of conventional agriculture, we used to plant the seedlings in rows. So in SRI, this wider spacing and square planting pattern gives plant roots and canopy more room to grow freely, and there is no competition for plant nutrients, water and sunlight. Lower plant population density also eliminates many unfavorable conditions that affect plant growth. The fourth principle of SRI is use of cono weeder to aerate the soil as well as controlling weeds. That means square planting uses the cono weeder operation in two directions. Thereby, weed management could be affected efficiently. In SRI, weeders should be used at 10 days interval from the date of transplanting. The water level should be properly monitored for usage of weeder. So that means the irrigation and cono weeder usage should be coincide. Weeds are buried into soil so that nutrients are not lost. The fifth principle is, water management is one of the critical steps in SRI. Plants should be given just enough water to meet the needs of the plants. Hence, alternate wet and drying is most accepted. Irrigation is only to moisten the soil rather than flooding. So, this alternate wetting and drying method rather than continuous flooding in the field is major principle in SRI. Whereas in conventional agriculture, farmer used to stand the water up to 5 cm. Whereas in SRI, we are standing the water in field up to 2.5 cm or thin film of water. The sixth principle of SRI is, the soil should be well supplied with organic matter. So we can use any organic manures, vermicompost or farmyard manure. Chemical fertilizer is applied according to soil test recommendation.
So after that, grading seeds by the salt water treatment. Grading seeds. Grading seeds by salt water. By salt water treatment. Okay. You see, it is necessary to use high quality seeds for increment of quality seed production. The unmatured, light and pest infected seeds have many bacterial diseases, which can be reduced by removing those seeds with salt water treatment. On field, or you can say unmatured seeds, chaffy seeds, pest infected seeds . So these are the seeds can be removed by using the salt water treatment. When paired seeds is dropped into salt water, damaged partially filled seeds, chaffy seeds, weed seeds and other inert materials which is lighter in weight will afloat, and good seeds will get sink in water. So when you drop the seeds into a vessel, so these are the seeds will float on the water surface and good seeds will get sink in water. So good seeds will get in sink in water. So these seeds can be discarded into outside, and those seeds deposited in bottom of the vessels can be used for further seed treatment.
Now let's see process of grading seeds by salt water treatment. Grading of seeds can be done at specific density of water 1.14. This specific gravity can be measured using hydrometer. To achieve specific gravity 1.14, we should mix around 2 kg salt or 3 kg ammonium sulfate in 10 liters of water in a bucket. If we don't have hydrometer, exact concentration of salt solution can be decided using egg or small potato.
For this, we require paddy seeds, an egg, adequate salts, and water in a vessels or in a bucket. Put egg into water and keep adding salts with well mixing until half of egg floats water surface. In this condition, density of water is 1.14.
Now put the paddy seeds into the water. Remove the floated seeds from the vessels. These floated seeds are mostly those seeds which are unmatured, damaged, and pest infected. Collect the well matured and healthy seeds which are settled on the bottom of the bucket and should be washed 2-3 times with clean water. By this way, we can select healthy seeds for our paddy cultivation in SRI method. Pseudomonas per kg of seeds should be added in water wherein seeds are soaked overnight before sowing in the nursery bed. Similarly, 10 gram azospirillum culture per kg of seeds can be mixed with sufficient water wherein seeds are soaked overnight before sowing in the nursery bed. The bacterial suspension after decanting may be poured over the nursery area itself. It helps to produce healthier and faster growth seedlings.
The next one is nursery preparation. So in SRI method, utmost care should be taken in the preparation of nursery bed, as 8 to 12 days old seedlings and in some places we are using 14 to 15 days old seedlings, that is 2 to 3 leaf stage are transplanted. So the nursery bed should be prepared in the corner or the center of the field. So here we are using commonly we are using 8 to 12 days old seedlings, and in some places the farmers using 14 to 15 days old seedlings. So the nursery bed preferably prepared in the corner of the plot for quick and efficient transplanting. So you can prepare over this place or in this place, any corner. Okay, so you can carry the seedlings easier to main field. Next one is preparation of soil mixture. So the nursery area for system of rice intensification, we required only 100 square meter. But in conventional method, where we required nursery area about 1000 square meter, that is in conventional, and this is for SRI. Okay, so for each 100 square meter of nursery, we required 4 cubic meter of soil mix. So we need 4 cubic meter of soil mix is needed for 100 square meter. Are you understand? Yes. So how can we prepare this soil mixture? Anyone? Yes. So what should we do? Mix 70% soil plus 20% will decomposed press mud, or you can use biogas slurry or farmyard manure also. 20% used well decomposed farmyard manure, okay, or any you can use press mud also, press mud, or you can use biogas slurry. And remaining 10% we can use rice hull. 10% rice hull. So by this way we can prepare the soil mixture for rice nursery. So next we are going to see filling in soil mixture. So how we are filling the soil mixture and nursery bed? So what should we do?
We are using wooden frame. If we use the wooden frame, place the frame on top of the banana leaf. Frame should be 50 cm long, 100 cm wide and 4 cm deep, divided into equal segments. Then fill the frame almost to the top with soil mixture you prepared.
Next one is preparation of main field. So land selected for SRI should be well leveled and should not have water logging condition. So when the plot is irrigated, the water should spread uniformly across the field. Similarly, whenever needed, there should provision to drain excess rainwater. So the field should be well leveled when the irrigation water applied in your field, the water should spread uniformly without standing anywhere. So this is the pre-indicator for preparation of main field. So similarly we must provide drainage facilities, because the main aim of SRI is should not stagnate the water rather than mush the soil.
Now let's see how to prepare the main field for SRI method. 12.5 tonnes well decomposed farmyard manure or compost should be uniformly applied 10 days before transplanting. Then plow the soil and puddle the field thoroughly by 2-3 times, followed by level the field to facilitate to use the marker. In SRI, the 8 to 12 days old seedlings are transplanted in main field. The seedlings should be planted in square planting system. You can plant the seedlings by 25 cm by 25 cm. That is, between the rows, the spacing should be 25 cm and plant to plant spacing is 25 cm. For this, we can use marker
to form the square line in the field. So it can allow to use the corner weeder.
So next one is weed management in system of rice intensification. So as we all know, weed grows much faster than our crop plants, and it absorbs more nutrients and at faster rate than our crop plants. So earlier weed management program should be executed to successful crop production. So in SRI, we never irrigating the field with the stagnation of water. So here we are maintaining alternate wetting and drying in SRI, results in excessive weed growth, if unchecked in time, may cause immense loss in yield. So alternate wetting and drying increase the weed population. Increase the weed population. So what should we do? We have to adopt better weed management at early stage of crop growth. So in SRI, we are using cono weeder to manage the weeds. In SRI, we are using cono weeders to manage the weeds.
In SRI, first weeding is to be done 10 to 12 days after planting. Further weeding may be undertaken depending on the necessity at 10 to 15 days interval until crop reaches panicle stage. As we discussed earlier, for smoother and easier operation of cono weeder, it is advisable to coincide the weeding with irrigation. The first advantage of using the cono weeder is the control of weeds and also adding organic matter to the soil. Further, the soil gets aerated and roots are exposed to air. This results in profuse growth of soil microorganism, which make nutrients available to the plants.
So next one is water management in system of rice intensification. Water management in system of rice intensification. So this is very much important in system of rice intensification, that SRI method does not require continuous flooding. So that means we are not standing the water up to 5 cm. So just we are giving the water and maintain a thin film of water in the field. So irrigation is given to maintain soil moisture near saturation initially, and water is let in when surface soil develop hairline cracks. So this is very much important. So when the soil develop hairline cracks, so that is the indicator for irrigating the field under SRI system. So the irrigation interval, however, vary with the soil moisture, soil texture, and climatic condition. Soil texture, environmental condition. So this is about water management. You see, as the soil is not flooded, as the soil is not flooded, the roots of the plant, this paddy plant, grow healthy deeply in all direction. It is proven that the system of rice intensification paddy crops grow numerous root system as compared to conventional method, because here we are adopting wide spacing, isn't it? In SRI method we are adopting wide spacing method. So this wide spacing facilitates numerous formation of roots. So as the field is intermittently irrigated and dried, the microorganism grow well, which make nutrients available to the plants. So this method also helps in better growth and spread of roots. So water should not allow stagnating, at least during vegetative growth stage. So suppose you irrigated water for rice crop. So what will happen? So the aeration will be restricted, you know, aeration will be restricted, then there is poor growth of roots as well as crop. Okay, so that's why we are irrigating the field under a system of rice intensification when hairline cracks develop in the soil. Okay, so water should not allow stagnating, at least during vegetative growth stage. So during reproductive stage, okay, during reproductive stage, a minimal standing water may be maintained. So that is 1 to 2 centimeter is sufficient. Okay, 1 to 2 centimeter would be sufficient during reproductive stage. During reproductive stage. Okay, so this is all about water management. So next one is nutrient management. Nutrient management. So this is last principles of system of rice intensification. Here you see organic manures or vermicompost are recommended in SRI cultivation as they give better responsive and improve soil health. So the main so one of the principles of system of rice intensification is to apply more organic manures. Okay, so application of farmyard manure or compost 10 to 12 tons per hectare before plowing is commonly recommended for system of rice intensification. 10 to 12 tons per hectare organic manures, or you can grow any or you can grow any green manure crops. Okay, so prior to system of rice intensification. And the nutrient management, particularly nitrogen management, is well managed by using leaf color chart. I think many of you know what is leaf color chart. So the concept of leaf color chart is based on a close link between chlorophyll and nitrogen content of leaves. Close link between chlorophyll and nitrogen content of leaves. Okay, so this leaf color chart is a potential tool to manage the nitrogen. So This leaf cluster chart can be used as quick and reliable tool for assessing leaf nitrogen status at different growth stages.
Now let's see how to measure the leaf color using leaf color chart. When the leaves are pale or yellowish green rather than dark green, farmers believe plants need more nitrogen. The leaf color chart consists of 6 green color shades from light yellowish green, which is number 1, and dark green, which is number 6 on chart. The guidelines for using the leaf color charts are: select the youngest and fully expanded leaf on single plant. This color is highly related to the nitrogen status of the plants. Measure the color of this leaf by placing it on middle of top of the charts. We do not detach the leaves from plants. Since sunlight intensity affecting the color of leaves, it is advisable to match the color of chart on shading of observer for comparing the color. If color of the rice leaves seems to fall between two colors, take mean value. Select 10 leaves randomly in a field. If more than 5 leaves showing reading below critical value, apply nitrogen top dressing immediately. The leaf color chart reading are normally taken on the 7 to 10 days starting 14 days after transplanting for transplanting rice, or the reading should be taken 21 days after sowing for direct seeded rice. You see, the critical leaf color value for nitrogen top dressing may range from 3 to 5 for different varieties. For example, the critical value is 3 for aromatic rice, 4 for semi-dwarf indica varieties, and 5 for hybrids. When leaf color shows less than critical value, nitrogen can be applied at the rate of 35 kg nitrogen per hectare in dry season and 30 kg nitrogen per hectare in wet season.
Dear students, now let's see comparison of system of rice intensification and conventional method of rice cultivation. So first one, we will see spacing. The first character is spacing. In conventional method, we are adopting rectangular method, that is spacing is 15 × 10 cm. Whereas system of rice intensification method, we are adopting square method, that is 25 × 25 cm. Okay, here we are adopting square method. Here in conventional method we are adopting rectangular method, and here it is square method. Next one is number of plants per square meter. Number of plants per square meter. In conventional method, the number of plants per square meter is 66, whereas in system of rice intensification we are maintaining number of plants per square meter is 16. You see, just we are maintaining plant population 16 per square meter. The next one is number of seedlings per hill. Number of seedlings per hill. So in conversion method, we are planting three plants per hill. Whereas in SRM method, we are adopting single seedling method. So we are planting single seedlings in a hill. So here we are using only one seedlings per hill. Next one is number of plants per hectare. So this number of plants per hectare can be determined by calculating plant population. So we already know what is the spacing for conventional method and what is the spacing for system of rice intensification method. So we can calculate plant population by using spacing between rows and plants. First we will do for conventional method. First we will do for conventional method. So what is the spacing for conventional method? That is 15 by 10 centimeter. So and you all know what is the square meter for 1 hectare. So for 1 hectare, that is 10,000 square meter, isn't it? Then spacing is 15 by 10 centimeter. Okay. So here we are using in meter, but here the denominator is centimeter. So this centimeter should be changed into meter. Okay. So now when we are converting into meter, now you see 0.15 into 0.1 meter. Okay. Now will come 0.015. 0.015. Okay. So this unit we can use. So now we will get 6,66,666 plants per hectare. Okay. So in conventional method, the plant population would be 6,66,666. Similarly, we can calculate for SRI method also. And this is 25 into 25 centimeter. Okay. Now this centimeter should be converted into square meter. So for that we have to change centimeter into meter. Okay. So now this will become 0.0625 and the answer will be 160,000 plant population. So in SRI we are maintaining 160,000 plant population. Okay. Then seed requirement. The next one is seed requirement. In conventional method, we are using 50 kg per hectare. 50 kg per hectare. Whereas in SRI method, we are adopting very low seed rate, and it is 5 to 7 kg only. Okay, 5 to 7 kilogram seeds in SRI method. Next one is number of hills required per square meter. Number of hills per square meter. Okay, so in conventional method, the number of hills per square meter will be 50, and in SRI, since we are adopting wider spacing between plant to plant and row to row spacing, we required only 16 hills per square meter. Okay, so this is all about comparison between conventional method and system of rice intensification method. You see the spacing here, rectangular spacing, but here square planting spacing, and the number of plants per square meter is here 66, but 16 number of plants per square meter. Then third one is number of seedlings per hill. In conventional method, we are adopting only 3, and here only single seedlings. And number of plants per hectare, the in conventional method, the plant population will be 666,666, whereas in SRI, here the plant population will be 160,000 only. Next one is seed requirement. In conventional method, the farmers adopting about 50 kg per hectare, whereas SRI, the seed rate will be only 5 to 7 kg per hectare. Then next one is number of hills per square meter. In conventional method, the number of hills per square meter is 50, and in SRI method it is 16. So this is all about comparison between SRI and conventional method. Next one is advantage of system of rice intensification method. So in SRI method, there are number of advantages as compared to conventional methods. The first and foremost advantage is saving in seed requirement. Saving in seed requirement. Okay, saving in seed requirement. Since single seedling used at wider spacing, we required low seed rate. Single seedling and at wider spacing. Okay, so we required low seed requirement. Next one is increased tillering. In SRI method, plants produced more number of tillers as compared to conventional methods. In SRI method, single plant produced normally 30 tillerings per plants. So fairly easy to achieve tillers per plant. Under well managed SRI condition, sometime plant produce more than 50 tillers also. Okay, so normally any plants under SRI method produce 30 tillers, but well managed SRI condition, the plant can achieve more than 50 tillers per plant. The next advantage is profuse root growth. Okay, in SRI method, we using conoveeder. Okay so implementation of this conoveeder, it control the weeds, simultaneously it aerate the soil soil also, aerate soil also. So it facilitates produce more number of roots as compared to conventional methods. You can find clear cut difference between SRI and conventional method seedlings. In SRI method, plant produce numerous amount of fresh roots than conventional methods. And fourth one is reduction in nursery area and duration. Okay, so this is also one of the major advantage in system of rice intensification SRI method. So in SRI, the nursery area we required just 100 square meter, whereas conventional method the nursery area is required about 1000 square meter. Okay, 1000 square meter in conventional methods, whereas in SRI we required only 100 square meters. Whereas and the duration, okay, so in SRI we are establishing seedlings about 12 days. Okay, so seedlings occupied in SRI method only 12 days, whereas in conventional method the seedlings occupied in nursery area is more than 20 days, and sometimes it may extend up to 30 days also. 20 to 30 days. Okay, so fifth advantage is water saving. Okay, so in SRI we can save the water up to 35% to 40% as compared to conventional method of rice cultivation. So here we can save the water by 35% to 40% as compared to conventional method of rice cultivation. Sixth one is less lodging. You see, SRI method create favorable condition for growth of plants and root formation results in less lodging, or you can say it's highly resistant to lodging. Seventh principle is reduce chemical fertilizer. Okay, since SRI using more amount of organic manures, it decreases the rate of chemical fertilizer application. Another one thing, that for nitrogen management we are using leaf clutch chart. That means when plants require nitrogen, then only we are applying fertilizers. The next advantage is increase yield up to 25%. Okay, so certainly SRI method could produce more yield as compared to conventional methods. So these are the major advantages of system of rice intensification. Okay, if you like this video, you will like, share, and don't forget to subscribe our channel for regular updating. Thank you.